Hi everyone, welcome to the channel. I'm August Bradley, and this is the series where we build a life operating system in Notion. The system we're building is called Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults. And in this video, I'm going to introduce the whole Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults system to those new to the channel, but I'm also going to share with those who have been following the whole series what Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults actually means, how those three categories relate to each other, because there's been a little bit of confusion and I just want to define it tightly. And I have a new diagram that shows you how these categories relate. And then I'm going to show how you get into the system if you're coming to it anew. So this will be the overview video on the Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults life operating system in Notion. Before we dive in, just wanted to mention we've just launched our online membership community with a lot of people very passionate about knowledge management, performance systems, life operating systems, and all these topics across productivity, mental clarity, systems thinking. And if you're interested in those topics, check out the Year Zero Collective. Year Zero is about fresh starts and reboots. It's all at yearzero.io. Now, in this series and in this approach to building a life operating system, we are big on systems thinking. Systems thinking is the ability to look comprehensively, holistically, at how various systems interact with each other and interact with the systems that they are a part of, the larger systems that they operate within. And when you take this very holistic view, you can see how qualities emerge, arise from the interplay across the system that doesn't exist in individual components. This is what makes a comprehensive life operating system in Notion so powerful. A lot of people approach Notion having little segments of their life, little pieces here and there in different Notion builds, but it's not comprehensively integrated. And that's where a lot of the power is. When you have it comprehensively integrated, you have this emergence where new capabilities, new powers, new insights reveal themselves. Faster ways of doing things arise. More knowledge is present when you're focused on a specific task. All of these different pieces complement each other when they're interconnected, and that's what this whole approach in Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults is all about. There's nothing wrong with doing little segments of your life in different parts of Notion or across different apps. But when you take it to the next level and really integrate everything, that's when a lot of these superpowers start to arise because of the interconnectivity and the way the different parts of your life are informing each other and revealing insights across the system that you wouldn't get if each piece was fragmented. If you're interested in systems thinking, the first few videos of this series, way back in the beginning, give an intro and an overview on what systems thinking is and how we're applying it here. But it permeates everything we do here. So first, we're going to start with a new diagram that simplifies the organizational structure of the Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults system. And then after that, I'll show you the interfaces that let us control the most important aspects of our lives. And the ultimate purpose of all of this is to accomplish three things: focus, alignment, and knowledge resurfacing at the right time and place. Focus so that when we sit down to do the work, we have the ability to focus on what matters and do the task at hand and get it done. That's easier said than done, but a well-designed system will help you do that, help you bring the focus to do the things that you tell yourself you're going to do. Alignment, so that the things we do day by day and hour by hour are directly aligned with our high-level aspirations. It's more important to do the right things inefficiently than to do the wrong things efficiently. And alignment ensures that every day, every hour, we're doing the right things. We're doing the things that are going to move our lives forward, that are going to help us become the people we want to be and help us achieve the things we want to achieve, whether that's work-related or family-related or pertains to mental clarity or creativity, creative output. All of these things require that the time we spend putting effort in is on the things that will move the ball forward, that will help us climb the mountain. It's so easy to make our list of goals, our list of aspirations, at the beginning of the year or even the beginning of a month, and then just drift away from them, lose sight of them as day by day we're pulled in different directions and everything becomes reactive. With a system like Pillars, Pipelines, and Vaults, we're able to stay on track with the things that matter because we have alignment across the system. We have direct connections between what we do hour by hour, day by day, week by week, month by month, up to our highest level aspirations that we have very clearly defined and articulated. So everything is done with intentionality and in a very deliberate way. And then finally, to be able to quickly capture ideas and information in this fire hose of media that we live in, to capture the pieces that have insight and meaning to us, bring them into a system that stores them in a very safe and organized and accessible way, then aggregates them into topic categories where our best thinking, the best wisdom, the best ideas we've come across all aggregate across each topic in what we call the knowledge vault. And then ultimately, that information is at our fingertips and arises almost magically in the right time and place because it's built into the system and the system knows what matters, when it matters and where it matters. So the system will have things bubble up in the right context, in the right time and place, when we need them, because they're captured in such a way that they were slotted into the right tracks to resurface in the right context. That's all part of the system we're building here. That's the vault section, the knowledge management component of the whole pillars, pipelines, and vault system. So with that, let's dive in. This shows the relationship between pillars, pipelines, and vaults. Let's first look at pipelines and vaults. Pipelines are the action in our life, the things that go through a process flow with various stages of progress and then ultimately completion. So it's tasks in the bottom database. Each of these cylinders is a database, a separate database in the system. So we have the action items or task database, the projects database, the goal outcomes database, and the value goals database. Don't worry about those, just think of them as a goals database. There's a separate video that explains the distinction between them. So this is progress and process flow. So this would relate to a system such as GTD, or getting things done. This is a different system, but this would cover the scope of GTD. Vault is about knowledge management, or personal knowledge management, or business context, business knowledge management. This would cover the scope of something like para, or building a second brain. That all fits within the vault section of the pillars, pipelines, and vaults system. Each of these is a database. So we have a lot of input databases like the media vault, where we capture books and articles and videos and podcasts and notes and ideas and highlights from all these pieces of information that we saw value in. We wanted to save them into our system so that that thinking, those ideas would be accessible to us later. And the system will organize these in a way that they will resurface at the right time and place and context. And that is the power of doing this in a comprehensive system. We have a database here on courses and training. This is where you would capture your notes. Then notes and ideas, this is where we capture our own thinking and put it in here so that it can also resurface at the right time and place. And then the tools and skills vault, when we review software, when we review professionals or companies that will help us in some way. We do put a lot of research in, we capture it, and then that research is available in the knowledge vault as we need it. There's a whole section of videos on personal knowledge management and the knowledge vault in particular that show how this resurfacing in context works, but this is the component of the system where that happens. So we've got the pipelines for action and getting things done. We've got the vaults for knowledge management. So what are pillars? Pillars are not at the same logical, hierarchical level as pipelines and vaults. They're something different. So while pipelines and vaults are running up vertically here, pillars are horizontal organizational categories across all of them. So every one of the pipelines and all the databases and elements within the pipelines and all the databases and elements within the vaults, each will be organized and sorted by pillars. Pillars are categorizations. They are breaking your life into segments such that everything you do will fall into one of these segments. It's not about a high standard. It's not about aspirations. It's not about vision. It's just about categorizing the whole spectrum of your life into different structural categories. Now, these are the big groupings of the categories: growth, home life, and business. And within these, within growth, we would have health and fitness. We would have mental clarity. Home life would have family. It would have friends. It would have social life. It would have personal finances. Business is going to have all the parts of your business: marketing, sales, product design, product development, customer operations. So each of these segments within these groupings is a pillar. These are the big groupings, but we can see how all the things that fit into the growth segment, all the things that fit into the home life, and all the things that fit into business will then across the pipelines and vaults organize and categorize everything within all of these database stacks underneath it. They're all organized by these different categories of your life that we call pillars. And then the one element outside of this system is the cycle reviews, because these are time-based. So these are not organized by pillars. These are periodic review cycles. So we're going to be doing weekly reviews, monthly reviews, annual reviews to make sure things are on track and see where things are getting derailed and pull them back in line. It's a very important balancing process to keep the system on track and going in the right direction so that we don't drift away from our goals. We don't drift away from our aspirations, as we're apt to do if we don't have these periodic review cycles where we check where we are relative to the path we've set for ourselves and realign any drifting that has happened. And then at the very bottom, the daily entries are the habits and routines, the things we want to improve in our lives that we're tracking on a daily basis to make sure we're moving forward. So we have habit trackers and we have data tracking to keep an eye on the things we've identified as most important. Not everything, just the most important things, because the things we track, we have insight into, and we know whether they're moving forward or not. And the very act of observing them dramatically increases the odds of them progressing forward. So pillars are just organization across all the different pipelines and vault elements. Pipelines are action-oriented process flow. Vaults are knowledge management, structuring it such that it will resurface at the right time and place. And that is the pillars, pipelines, and vault system. That's what it does. That's how it's organized. So I wanted to share this just to give you that overview. Now, for those new to the system, I just want to show you the top-level dashboards so you can get a little bit of a look at the window into the system. So this is the command center. This is the top-level dashboard for the entire system. It's the top-level window into how the whole system works. The system is all about focus and alignment. So in red, the very first column here is focus and alignment. Within that, we have the action zone and alignment zone. The three big mega dashboards in the system are the command center that we're in, the action zone, which is all about focus, focusing on what we're doing throughout the day. It's the daily view of what we're doing hour to hour, and I'll show you that in a moment, and the alignment zone. The alignment zone is what ensures that the things we're doing day to day are aligned with our high-level aspirations through the project level, the goal level, and the guiding principle level. So it'll keep our highest level values and our highest level aspirations in sync with what we're doing day to day and hour to hour. And if you can do that, you're going to move things forward. Your life's going to move forward. Your business is going to move forward. The things you want to accomplish in life will happen, and you will ultimately become the person you want to become because you're steadily, consistently making progress in the direction you have designed for yourself. Then we have three categories here. These are the three pillar categories that we saw here: growth, home life, business, the categorizations. These are the groupings. And within those groupings, we now see the individual pillars. We see for growth, health and fitness, mental clarity, learning. We see for home life, family, home and household, personal admin and finance. We see for business, team and administration, client operations, content creation, product development. These are my pillars. You can define these however you want. You're basically going to break your whole life out into anywhere between 5 and 15 categories, and everything will break out, and they will be grouped by growth, home life, and business, and laid out here. Every single one of these is the dashboard. You'll click on those, and you'll have a sub-dashboard into that section of your life. All of the pipeline elements, the action-oriented process flow, getting things done, elements of your life within each of these will be presented in an organized in clear way that brings a lot of transparency into what's moving forward and what's stuck. And all of the knowledge, the ideas, the wisdom and insight that you've either captured from other sources or entered from your own thinking will also resurface across each of these categories in those dashboards. So each of these is a dashboard into that slice of your life, and they're organized by these groupings. And then down here, we have databases. This is the organizational structure of the Notion assets. So pillars will have the pillar structure, which is what these entries are up here. Pipelines is, again, the databases we saw in that previous diagram. The tasks, which I call action items, is the task database, projects, and goals. Then some specialty pipelines. If you happen to do content creation, I've got a content creation pipeline. If you work with clients, I've got a client operations pipeline. Those are down here as well. They're part of the pipelines section of the system. And then finally, the vaults, which is all about knowledge management. We've got the global vaults and we've got some specialty vaults. All of these are designed to resurface the right information at the right time, making it super valuable because it's at your fingertips in the right context. We have the ability to do quick capture for notes and meeting ideas here. And we can embed widgets, things that are useful, keyboard shortcuts, weather, whatever might be useful. Just drop it in these embedded segments if you want. And that is the on-ramp to everything else in the system. To just quickly show you two more dashboards to get a sense of how this actually works day to day, the alignment zone is how we align our high-level aspirations with our daily actions and hourly actions. We start with our guiding principles. We define what is meaningful to us in life, what we value through a process here. We then define our pillars, which are the categorizations we've talked about. Pillar support are things that help you implement and achieve what matters within each pillar. So we have a section where we design habits and routines. We have knowledge vault items from the vaults that are related specifically to the pillars. Again, this is pillar support. Mindset and identity sculpting work, where we shape our mind and our identity, how we see ourselves into the person we want to be, into the person we need to become in order to achieve the things we want to achieve, and health and fitness. All of that supports and enables success across our pillars. Then we set our goals, our high-level aspirational goals, and then our measurable, quantifiable, tangible steps towards our goals, the outcomes that will get us to our ultimate aspirations, which are value goals, the goals based on the things we value most in life. And then we break our goal outcomes down into individual projects to help achieve those goal outcomes, or we define habits and routines that will help us achieve those goal outcomes. And then finally, the projects break down into tasks. That is how we achieve alignment. And through cycle reviews, annual, monthly, weekly review cycles, we keep everything on track. And if we start drifting away, we realign it. And finally, the action zone is how we run our lives day to day. So we have this toggle here for today, which has basically a to-do list. Everything is organized by due date, not the DUE date, but the DO date, the date on which we intend to do the item. These are all spread out across the calendar. Each day has its own task list defined by the DO dates. The task list for each day lets you have a series of short task lists rather than a giant to-do list that is just a burden that will never get done and just seems hopeless. You have short lists for each day that are achievable. They may be reaches, but they're doable. And so you have the chance of actually completing everything you set out to do that day, which is incredibly empowering. The idea of these giant, heavy to-do lists that are endless and will never get done is just burdensome and it's exhausting and it's impossible to actually live that way. So we plan out the next week, potentially two, with individual to-do lists for each day. Things may roll and adjust as they need to, but it's a rough outline of the next week or two. And it gives you a much more manageable, much more transparent view on what you need to accomplish each day. Down here, we have client operations. So each client we have would be laid out here with a card and all the information for each client. We'd have active projects. So the projects that we've defined as active for this time period would be laid out here. And within those projects, we can see all the tasks in order that we need to achieve. We turn a few of them on active and the rest are queued up to be addressed in the future. And then finally, our goal outcomes. And that brings incredible clarity. After my morning startup, I spend my whole day in this one today toggle with that one list. And I just go through them one at a time, queued up in order, immediate, quick, scheduled items if there's a specific time, then first, second, third, fourth priority, any errands, reminders, it's all queued up. I work through it in order. The night before, I set this today priority list. So when I come into the office the next day, it's queued up for me. There's clarity on what I need to do and the sequence in which I need to do it. There's no wondering what I should do and getting distracted and drifting off. There's a clear plan of action every day when I come in because the night before, I have set up the to-do list for the next day. And that's pretty much it. There's lots of nuance and lots of empowering features built within and a lot of connectivity from one part to another that automates and brings the right information into the right place and gives you alerts when things are going off track. But this brings total clarity to your day, keeps you on track with the things that you've defined are most important to you and gets them done, all while capturing the information that you find most valuable and bringing it to the surface in the right place when you need it and keeping it out of the way when you don't need it so that you only focus on the things that matter now and you only have the information that you need to do the thing that you're focused on. Pillars, pipelines, and vaults organize every aspect of your life. Everything you do fits into it. Everything you need to know and every action that has to take place is all contained neatly within this overall structure, and it flows in a way that's intuitive, gives you incredible transparency on what's working and what's not so that you can adjust as needed, helps you learn faster, helps you move faster, helps you grow faster. It just empowers you in every aspect of your life. That's why I'm so excited about it and why I've committed so much time and energy to laying this all out in this channel. If that's of interest, we've got a whole series that lays out each individual aspect of the whole system. All of these components are drilled down in individual detail in all the videos across this whole series. If you want to share ideas and explore further with other people who are excited and passionate about building these kinds of life operating systems, consider joining our online community. It's a membership community called the Year Zero Collective. That's all available at yearzero.io. I'm also very active on Twitter and happy to engage in a broader range of ideas there. If this is of interest, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get updates on future videos. Leave thoughts or questions below and hit like if you found this valuable. I also read a newsletter called Mind and Machine on Increasing Human Capability. I give away several of my best Notion templates to anyone who subscribes to the newsletter. You can, of course, unsubscribe at any time, but I hope you'll give it a chance. I work super hard to pack it with a lot of valuable insight. The newsletter link is also below in the show notes. Thanks for watching. Lots more to come.